Hi, and welcome to another edition of Does This Have Gum In It? I'm Harold Nicoll. I'm the marketing manager here at TIC Gums, and I'm joined, as always, by the gum guru, Maureen Akins. Welcome, Maureen.
Thank you.
We're going to talk about cheese sauces and dairy. More specifically, on this edition, we're going to talk about fat. There are a lot of very positive things about fat, but there's some negative things as well. Before we, though, get into some of the dietary and other issues that people think of when they think about fat, let's talk about the positives. What does fat do for us in terms of experiencing food?
Sure, fat's one of the greatest food items that you can have. Ingredient formulators love to use fat in their formulations because it provides fantastic mouthfeel, provides this excellent coating on your mouth. It also helps relay flavors very nicely too. So things that come to mind specifically would be dairy ingredients. You always want to have full fat dairy ingredients because they do provide you with that wonderful mouth sensation and that satiety that kind of helps you through the meal that you're eating.
So it sounds like fat is really experiential in how it helps to communicate flavor inside your mouth. Is that a fair statement?
Absolutely.
So when we also think about fat, we think about calories and vein clogging and heart disease.
The bad side.
All of the bad things
That's
that are
right.
associated with fat.
That's right.
But we don't want to necessarily trade the good experiences with fat for less enjoyable ones.
That's right. There's a fine balance between giving yourself a more nutritious, maybe better balanced formulation versus a formulation that you know is very indulgent and delicious, but may not be, from a nutritional perspective, the best thing for you to do. So the food formulators actually need to find a nice balance between what we would call a gold standard formulation, full fat formulation, and those that maybe are geared more towards those who are a bit more health conscious.
Okay, so as all of us get older and become more aware of the negative aspects of fat, what will food scientists do to maintain the experience without the downside?
Lots of ways that you can help mimic fat in formulations. We're going to talk about a couple of great examples of sauces that have been made with about 15 to 20% less fat, but you get the same eating experience. And all that is through the magic of gums.
Gums are used a lot in different kinds of fat mimicking.
That's right.
Fat mimicking that's kind of the holy grail of food science.
It is, and it's very difficult to get it completely correct. And there are ways that you can kind of go around it, but from a textural aspect, there are several key areas that you can kind of focus on, and those would be certainly making sure that you have the correct viscosity and making sure that you find a way to mimic all of those mouth coating mouth staying functionalities that you get out of fat.
Because like you said earlier, it's how long the sauce stays on your palate. A waterier sauce would just roll right off the ravioli onto the plate.
Absolutely. Another aspect of fat is that it does have solid characteristics, and those solid characteristics help it cling and add a nice, beautiful presentation to things like ravioli, like we're going to look at today. So not only do you have to pay attention to how you experience it in your mouth, but you also have to pay attention to what it looks like in its finished form.
Sure, because eating is a total sensory experience. It starts when you look at it.
That's right.
Ends even during and after
Absolutely.
Swallowing. So we have two different plates of ravioli here
Yes.
today, and these were actually made here at TIC Gums.
Mm-hmm.
And we demonstrated these at the RCA earlier this year.
That's right.
We have Ticaloid Saucier and Ticaloid Ultra Smooth.
That's right.
Why did we pick these two hydrocolloids?
Really good example of how you can use different combinations of gums to come up with equivalent results. So in this case, with the Ticaloid Saucier, we've actually used a combination of emulsifying agents, our modified gum acacia, our patented tick emulsion product, in conjunction with starch and xanthan to give you both the emulsification properties and that viscosity mouthfeel portion that you lose when you remove fat.
And then for the Ultra Smooth.
Ultra Smooth uses a completely different mechanism in that it's actually just working on increasing viscosity, but then using a bit of carrageenan, which is very well known to work in conjunction with dairy ingredients to provide you with fantastic mouthfeel.
So Maureen, we've talked about how hydrocolloids can be used to imitate or mimic fat as it behaves on the plate and while you're eating it. Let's talk about the bottom line. If you substitute these gum systems for the fat from cream and milk, do you save money?
Using hydrocolloids is a fantastic way to optimize the costs of your formulations. Certainly here, if you were able to take out 15 to 20% fat, dairy fat is very expensive. Certainly fat from cheese, which goes through many additional processing steps, is very expensive. So if you can find a way to replace all of those values that you get out of fat using a hydrocolloid, you are almost always going to save yourself money on the bottom line.
And if I'm hearing you right, we don't have to substitute or settle for a less satisfying product.
That's right. That's the whole intent. Making sure that you choose the right hydrocolloids, you use them in the correct proportions relative to the amount of fat that you're removing from the system, will allow you to create a very comparable product.
I want to shift gears because we've talked about the sauce. I want to talk about the ravioli itself because there's actually one of our products that went into the filling of the ravioli. Can you tell us about that?
That's right. And in the filling itself, we've actually used a bit of cellulose gum. It's our CMC 15,000. It's very high viscosity, high molecular weight CMC. And it really does a great job for things like ravioli that get frozen. CMC is able to manage water beautifully during freeze-thaw cycling, which means it can hold on to that water, prevent large ice crystals from forming, which are actually very detrimental to flavor. So once you actually heat up this product after it's been frozen, it will eat as if you never froze it at all.
That's excellent to know. And for those of you who are watching, we have recipes for the sauces and the ravioli on our website if you want to go there and download that. And we also have the texture maps that we use to develop the sauces so that they would very, very closely mimic the full fat versions. That's going to do it for this edition of Does This Have Gum In It? Come back next time with myself, Harold Nicoll, and Maureen Akins. Thanks for watching.